Hi, iSanctuary. I'm Lauren Heydinger, and I am going to show you how to make my copper and burlap necklace and the matching pair of earrings.
First, you're going to start by planishing a large sheet of copper to create a nice, subtle texture. On the back of the sheet of copper, you're going to mark out each square for the necklace and the earrings. There should be 20 squares total. After your squares are marked, you're going to cut them out. Run some sandpaper over your tubing and then cut it out. There should be 40 3.5 millimeter long tubings total. Back to the copper plates now. You're going to use a disc cutter to punch holes in the copper plates, and they will be sporadically placed throughout the necklace and the earrings. There are three different sizes, small, medium, large, and make sure you spread them out to create a cool design. On your front plates, use a center punch to punch holes to get ready for drilling, and then go ahead and drill your holes in the four corners. After that, go ahead and repeat the process with the back plates, making sure that your holes line up perfectly with the ones in the front plates. Trace the squares onto the burlap to get the correct sizing, and then cut them out. Now it's time for the surface treatment for the plates. You're going to use a liver of sulfur patina that you just brush onto the surface, and then you're going to rinse it with cold water to stop the reaction. The color will be a light purplish color. Then you're going to use a brass brush and shine up the surface and clean off any extra residue that you may have. After you dry your piece off, you're going to take some polishing paper and lightly rub it over the surface to bring out the nice subtle texture. After all of your pieces have the patina, you are going to put a little dab of glue opposite of where the hole is and place your piece of burlap in place. You want to make sure that it stays clear of the holes that the rivets will go through. Now it's time to assemble all of the pieces. You're going to take your tubing and put it through the holes of both pieces, and you're going to make sure it's a nice snug fit so nothing goes anywhere. Then you're going to use your hammer and hammer down the ends of the tubing to make sure everything is secure and that it doesn't move. Now it's time to assemble everything. This is when your piece will really start to come together and look amazing. You're going to take three chain links and you're going to attach the end tube to both pieces and have one in the middle that allows for really nice movement when it's worn on the body. Once your piece is fully assembled, you can go ahead and put an 18-inch chain around the neck and attach a lobster clasp. The earrings will have a series of 7 chain links, where the one in the middle will be the one that is connected to the ear hook. Once everything is put together, you can take a step back and admire your handiwork.
I hope you have as much fun making these pieces as I did. Thanks for watching.